Good morning. Welcome to the weekly TreasuryONE video update. We are talking today just after the US FOMC meeting last night, where they decided to keep interest rates unchanged and citing that inflation is still not at their 2% core target. Joining me today to discuss what that means for the markets is Andre Cilliers, currency strategist at TreasuryONE. Good morning, Andre. So we've seen emerging markets rally a bit on this, dollar a bit weaker. What do you make of the announcements last night by the Fed Chair, Jerome Powell?
Yes, good morning, Richard, and good morning, everybody else. What do I make of it? Well, it's a little bit more of what was expected. I mean, the rhetoric thing about the FOMC in the last couple of meetings last year, I almost want to say the last 3-4 years, was they need to see 2% inflation. If they do not see 2% inflation, core inflation, they will not move on the short-term interest rates. What was added and what was still said is that they will still keep on printing money. They will still keep on putting more bond purchases, etc., into the market, adding liquidity into the short-term to stimulate the economy. So more of the same. No move on short-term rates, more money to stimulate the economy, and more emphasis on growth in the economy. And that simply means that emerging markets will perform a little bit better because, one, there's interest rates that is much higher in the emerging market space than in America or in Europe. So people will still be seeking yield for the bond purchases in South Africa and other emerging markets. And two, the fact that more money and more effort are being placed on stimulating economies, promoting growth, which that simply also translates to emerging market spaces doing better because they will feed off that growth and their own economies will also grow a little bit better. So what does that hold in for people at these levels? I think that the Rand had moved a little bit too fast once again, but that's one thing about the Rand, always overreacts to the positive and the negative side. So for the moment at these levels, we're at the bottom end of our forecasted long-term trading range of 14.5, 15.5, below the sort of mid space of that of 1480 to 1520. So to me, it looks like the importers should be looking at buying some dollars, taking some forward cover, whilst I think once again the exporters could hold off a little bit and wait for slightly better levels before they take cover. But once again, and we really mentioned this several times now, when we get to the 1520, 1530 levels, if we see that, then that is the space where the exporters should be taking forward cover and should be looking at hedging themselves, especially since the forward points are still in their favor. So for the moment, more emphasis on the import side, looking to take cover, and if we move a little bit higher, then the exporters should jump in again. But we're going to see the same FOMC meeting month after month. They will not move unless they see higher inflation.
So, yeah, thanks, Andrew. Just to tie into that, what we saw in the emerging market space overnight is we saw Brazil also hike interest rates overnight. Their repo rate was like a 2% hike overnight by 75 basis points. So they had 275. And I also hinted that at their next meeting, they might also hike further another 75 basis points, which will also make their yield attractive. So it just emphasizes the fact that yield in the emerging markets is still there and they're looking for that money, all that extra excess cash that the Fed is printing. Emerging markets is definitely the place to go. So, so importers make use of the opportunity here. Exporters, if you see, like Andre said, a little bit weaker, let's take cover. If there's anything else you want to add to that, Andre?
No, not really at this stage. I think I look at what some of our customers have done, then they have certainly looked at those higher levels to take some forward cover. There is still some orders in. So I would just stick to that program and do exactly what we've said. forward cover above the 1520 levels, for the exporters 1460, 65 levels, buy dollars for the importers.
Thank you so much for your time, Andre. Have a wonderful day.
Same to you. Thank you.